Okay. Witam serdecznie. Moimi gośćmi są twórcy filmu Redland, Aziel Norton i Magdalena Zyzak. During the OFF Festival Camera, we have here yesterday a premiere of Redland. Mm-hmm. And I just wonder how this festival found itself on this festival, how it was possible.
Mm-hmm. We were invited here due to Trevor Groth, who's the programmer from Sundance, and he chose films to play here. I guess there's a connection. They've built a connection between this festival and Sundance, and so they're building like a relationship. So it was to Trevor that we got here.
Did you show your movie earlier on during Sundance?
We showed our movie at a different festival that Trevor runs called Cine Vegas, and we've showed it at a number of festivals already. Yeah.
Films tells a story that is set in during 20s or 30s in the United States, or is it? Can we say that it's universal? It's about people and nature, about forgiving themselves or fighting with each other.
The film, the setting is in, you know, is in the 1930s America in the Great Depression, but the feeling that we had making the film was for a time period that for the time period almost appear ambiguous. That we wanted to create exactly what you're saying, a universal feeling and a sort of a dreamlike feel. So sort of outside of time, it could have taken place earlier, you know. And the people are so poor too, so their way of life is retrograde for their time. So that was definitely intentional, yeah, for sure.
I know that you were working on a script together. Mm-hmm. So how long you know each other? Do you work together?
Well, we met at the film school at USC. And we became a couple, actually.
And we
fell in love. And basically, we decided to make a movie because at the time we were almost done with school. Aziel has just graduated, so yeah, we just basically wrote the script together. And do you want to talk a little bit how it came about?
Sure. We went to film school together, got together, and then we decided we're gonna make a movie. You know, it was actually Magdalene. Well, obviously we went to film school. We wanted to make a movie, but Magdalene said, "Let's go.
Let's just wanted to
go
for
raise
it
money,
right away,
make a movie." You know,
yeah.
And so we started to think about ideas, and I had an image in my head. Film ideas in general that come to me in images. The film is very visual, and I'm a very visually oriented person. So I had an image in my mind of a man in a hat, with the brim of his hat shading his face so you couldn't see his face, firing a rifle. And I was just captivated by this image, just thinking about this image. And I thought, who is this man? Like, what's he doing? And I thought, he's hungry. He's hunting. He's trying to feed his family. His family's hungry. And then we started thinking about who his family was. Basically, we built the idea that his daughter would be a holy fool, which is, you know, a common Russian archetype. And so we started to build the idea off that relationship. And then also, I would have to add that during that time also, my dad was diagnosed with cancer, and he was dying throughout the writing of the script, and he died right before shooting. So I think that definitely informed the script.
Talking about inspiration, what inspires you, like, during the making movies? Like, personally, when I was watching this movie, I've seen some photographs from this era.
Yeah.
I've seen some songs of Tom Waits or Nick Cave or something like that, or old westerns.
I think a lot of the inspiration came from visual references. We're looking at paintings by Rembrandt, for example, Caravaggio. A lot of photographs by Dorothea Lange.
We built up a visual reference book of Dorothea Lange photos and also different paintings and that I admire, and also film stills from films that I admire. Grapes of Wrath was a film shot by John Ford directed, but shot by Greg Toland, great cinematographer. We were looking at that and looking at all sorts of great cinematographers that we admire and just building the look. How are we going to make this movie look? And also, we wanted to hook the way the film looked. We wanted to hook up into the sort of the theme of the film, because I think for me, a film or work of art works when every element of the film is going toward the same purpose. So this film, in many ways, is about life at its most basic level. So I wanted the film itself to reflect that. I wanted the look of the film to be alive. So we would do all sorts of crazy processes to make the film breathe and seem like something organic. And at the same time, it seem antique, like it's of the era. And at the same time, also be attractive, you know? So those were all the ideas that me and Zora and the DP were playing with.
Talking about cooperation, how you find your cinematographer? How you find the connection?
You know, thing to hire a cinematographer. So we started just looking into people's reels. And we got his reel, and it was a very good reel. And so, you know, we sucked down, we interviewed him. And like when I showed up to interview him at this coffee shop, I came and I sat down and he was reading Tarkovsky Sculpting in Time. And when I saw he was reading Tarkovsky Sculpting in Time, I just knew he was the guy to do it. He was going to be the DP.
Awesome. And how you found the actors?
We just did casting, you know, for months of casting, open calls, so just seeing many actors.
It took a long time because we wanted all the actors to look like they belong to the same family, but we also don't want them to look too modern, you know, because obviously the place that the film is taking place in the 1930s.
Yeah. So, exactly. Yeah, and you want people whose face open up to the camera, look good on camera, but aren't too like a model or something, you know. So it's like a.
They're so attractive.
And they have to be really be able to act in this country and like all this type of stuff. So it's complicated. Mm-hmm. You know?
I would like to ask also about the music. I heard that it was written specially for the movie. What can you say about it, that some instruments were built for it?
Yeah. The composer, T.K. Broderick, we went to school, he's actually also went to school with us. And yeah, we actually worked on the soundtrack for this movie for over a year. Because we were doing a lot of experimenting with different instruments and changing instruments and playing instruments how they shouldn't be played and doing all sorts of interesting stuff. Just kept experimenting, finding what the sound. First, we were doing more normal soundtrack, and it wasn't working. And then we started doing stuff like a violin bow to a banjo, and started playing the banjo like a violin, and like all sorts of different things like this. And then that's how we started to, you know, find the soundtrack.
Magda, I know that you are also a producer of the movie. How you found the financial background for yourself, or how you find the money to make
well,
this movie?
I guess we were lucky enough to know some people who are willing to invest, private investors, and who just believe in our vision, you know, so we had a complete artistic freedom, which is a luxury nowadays.
You have the movie without logos, so you can sell your products or something, so it was really great that they agreed, yes.
We're looking for money for film funds for our next project that we want to shoot in Galicia. It's a film that takes place in 1941. It's called Here I Sing, and it's about a Jewish woman hiding in the mountains with her baby, struggling to survive, and during 1941 when Germans were invading the East, you know. So we're definitely like, you know, talking to people of different countries and all this type of thing to get film funds, you know.
Do you want to shoot it in Poland?
Yeah, we do.
This is a possibility.
No, I mean, we prefer to, but, you know, it depends on, you know, finances, you know. I know Slovakia has some good deals, and, like, finding who can give us a good deal to shoot, I think, you know.
Thank you for your time. Yeah. Thank you for the meeting. Thank you for a wonderful movie.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.